Violent BLM is back for Christmas with a nasty surprise for Trump they've been plotting for months. Because Black Lives Matter hate everything that America stands for, they are now preparing a nasty surprise for Trump as he celebrates this awesome economy that we haven't seen in decades. Since President Trump is the epitome of everything that is America and our capitalistic society, the terrorist group that is Black Lives Matter has taken it upon themselves to boycott everything that is white. And why, you might ask? Because of so-called racism. Can anyone imagine the backlash from the liberal loons and the left-wing mainstream media if a white group called for a boycott of everything that is black? The cries of racism would be never-ending. Black Lives Matter organizes Black Christmas to divest from white corporations and white capitalism. Dr. Melina Abdullah, a professor at California State University Los Angeles, CSULA, who is also a national Black Lives Matter, BLM, leader, is urging allies to support the movement's Black Christmas this holiday season by divesting from white corporations. She claims white capitalism is an American institution that is inherently racist, therefore black people should pursue more collectivist approaches to economic empowerment. We say white capitalism because it's important that we understand that the economic system and the racial structures are connected, said Abdullah, a founding member of BLM who leads its Los Angeles chapter, BLMLA. We have to not only disrupt the systems of policing that literally kill our people, but we have to disrupt the white supremacist, capitalistic, patriarchal, heteronormative system that is really the root cause of these police killings. Abdullah, who descends from a family of Marxist organizers, made the comments on her weekly KPFK radio show called Beautiful Struggle, which features songs like 5 Million Ways to Kill a CEO's bumper music. She was joined by Dr. Anthony Radcliffe, also a professor at CSULA, who organized BLM's first youth activist camp last summer. Black Lives Matter and other organizations build a strong critique and understanding of racism and white supremacy and sexism and homophobia, transphobia, but we have to have as much hatred or vitriol against capitalism, Radcliffe said. Until we start to see capitalism just as nefarious as white supremacy, we will always be struggling. BLM launched a Black Christmas website on Saturday which calls for no spending with white corporations the New Year's Day, encouraging supporters to donate to allied, black-led community groups or black-owned businesses instead. The website goes on to state, Donald Trump embodies white capitalism. If you are anti-Trump, you should hold back your resources from him and the like. We are socialized to believe that the answer to white oppression is black capitalism, said Abdullah. We don't need any black millionaires and multimillionaires, and we don't need a black Walmart. That doesn't free us. In Los Angeles, BLM activists are organizing around historical, communal economic models that were implemented by free black people during the era of slavery. On the radio show, Radcliffe and Abdullah spoke of building black mutual aid societies and black co-ops as alternatives to the existing capitalist structure that requires dismantling. In order to get free as a collective, we have to think collectively, said Abdullah. It's not enough for one person to draw a profit because that also drains community. It needs to be structured around this idea of collective uplift. BLM has promoted Black Christmas every year since its founding, however many people remain unaware of its anti-capitalist motivations. As Dr. Abdullah wrote in the Los Angeles Sentinel, this call is fundamentally tied to Black Lives Matter's mission to end state-sanctioned violence against black people. We know that state-sanctioned violence is rooted in white supremacist capitalism. Since its inception in 2013, Black Lives Matter has recognized the killing of black people at the hands of the police as not simply a question of a few rogue officers, but a part of a system that is built on the backs of black people. We live under a system of white supremacist capitalism that exploits black people as workers and consumers and relies on the police state to secure and maintain its dominance. Previous Black Christmas demonstrations in Minneapolis, San Francisco, and LA resulted in activists blocking traffic near major airports during peak times of the holiday rush, inconveniencing many travelers. Last year, BLM disrupted Christmas Eve brunch at the Trump National Golf Club in Rancho Palos Verdes, California. According to LACED, protesters entered the dining hall and began singing protest carols, or classic Christmas carols reworded with mainly anti-Trump lyrics, to the patrons. Sadly, now that the malcontents have moved on from trashing Thanksgiving as a racist holiday against Native Americans, they have now gone to the war with Christmas, and since there are only 27 shopping days left to spoil the season for others, they just can't seem to be able to help themselves. The Los Angeles chapter of Black Lives Matter, of course that had to come from California, is doing their part to actively promote Black Christmas as a protest against President Trump. While falsely representing the effort to bolster African American businesses, the message via the group's website makes it abundantly clear this is just another temper tantrum because Donald Trump is the president. This has to be one of the sickest displays of racism I have ever witnessed being done here in America. In their hate for President Trump, the people seem to forget that the so-called racist Americans didn't go to Africa to pick them up and make them slaves. Their own people sold them off to Muslim traders who in turn sold the slaves to Americans so they could work the fields. But even if this fact offends you, there is one awesome fact about America. Our doors are wide open and you can go back to Africa whenever you like. Or do you prefer our benefits more? It's more?